The construction of the Grand Egyptian Museum, GEM, Phase 3, is now in its 20th month of the contract project duration of 40 months, with 616 calendar days remaining to reach the contract time for completion date of the 4th of July 2015. The Grand Egyptian Museum, GEM, is an iconic facility providing panoramic views of the magnificent Giza pyramids. It will house a large number and large artifacts which are beyond the capacity of the existing downtown Cairo building, which opened in 1902. Construction is predominantly a reinforced concrete frame on pad and strip foundations with major areas of structural steel framing. A significant part of the works remains still to be designed under the provisional sums and contracted design elements. The civil excavations and permanent concrete works are progressing on a multitude of fronts, with internal MEP and block work activities progressing in the basement tunnel and on the ground floor of the conference center. Outside the main building, civil works have progressed in the northwest corner of the site with the construction of the multifunction parking complex, which will provide parking and office facilities for the museum administrative and support staff. Ramses II statue stands proudly watching over day and night construction activities until the day he will be relocated into the entrance court that will greet the millions of visitors that will be mesmerized by the sheer scale and beauty of what will be the largest archaeological museum in the world. South view looking towards the magnificent and impressive Giza pyramids with the Sierpinski stairs, raft and walls to level 1 progressing that will eventually provide access for the public connecting the museum pyramid restaurants with the lower piazza area where the ticketing building will receive the thousands of coaches adjacent to the Alexandria Desert Road main public entrance. Sweeping views of the museum, civil works and backfilling works that are progressing concurrently on multiple levels from ground to first and first to second floor levels around the clock. Eastern views over the areas being prepared for the precast storage yard and subcontractors' laydown areas. The primary logistics and supplies to site are arriving from the Alexandria Desert Road, as well as the buses that bring in excess of 3,500 laborers per day. This is also the area that houses the three batching plants, with two providing the gray structural concrete and one the feature white cement concrete that is indeed the first time in Egypt that white concrete will feature. Adjacent to the batching plants is the carpentry yard, providing all the formwork on site, mortar required by the masons, and reinforcement cut and bending facilities that serve all the site reinforced concrete civil work needs. Excavated site material is stored on site, and that material which is tested and approved is stockpiled and used for the day and night backfilling operations across the site. The predominant areas where backfilling works are in progress are to the Menkaura's wall situated to the west of the site, the multifunction parking complex to the northeast, Sierpinski Stairs and Museum Zone 3 and Zone 2 situated in the southern regions of the site. The backfilling progresses in 20 centimeters layers and on the completion of 100 centimeters, a deep sand cone test is undertaken and once approved, the next cycle of backfill progresses. tower crane TC-10, which services Pour E and F of the museum, which is located in the east, provides the craneage for a multitude of civil works currently progressing, such as the raft foundations on level 2, retaining and internal walls and columns from level 2 to level 3, as well as completing walls and columns in zone 0 and zone 1 from first to second floor levels. Concurrent waterproof membrane works are progressing that will allow screed works and reinforcement to progress to level 2 raft slab foundation works. Tower crane TC-8, which is centrally located to the west of TC-10, provides the craneage requirements to the museum Pour S, C, D, and E, and which is statistically the busiest tower crane on the project. View from the entrance court, looking at the museum, white concrete raking walls to the south and the conference center to the north, with both these civil works progressing on multiple fronts from level 1 to level 3. The entrance court, which will be graced by the magnificent Ramses II statue surrounded by water features, will greet the millions of visitors from all four corners of the world, will create the perfect welcome and last impressions for generations to come. Aerial view from men basket suspended from tower crane TC-6 to the north of the site, looking back over the completed reinforced concrete works to the conference center, Minka Rao's walls and the museum with the imposing Giza pyramids to the south. Extent of the vast areas of logistics and materials handling, which provide the backbone and support structure feeding the permanent works, such as the carpentry workshop, batching plants, reinforcement prefabrication, first aid and medical facilities, labor and rest areas can be appreciated from the aerial view that indeed take up a considerable floor footprint. All these temporary and support facilities will be demobilized to make way for the permanent water features, landscape and paved areas, as well as the main ticketing, booth and parking facilities to the east of the site adjacent to the Alexandria Desert Road. Aerial view from tower crane TC-6, looking north to the existing site buildings in the northeastern corner of the site, where the initial site offices were established and that currently house some subcontractors. These are planned to be demolished in early 2014, and also the relocation of Ramses II statue, currently housed in a protective cladded structure, will be eventually relocated into his final resting place in the museum entrance court. The extent of the site temporary access roads and stockpiles of sand can also be appreciated, which are constantly being revised in line with the site requirements. To the northwest is the multi-function parking complex, which is progressing out from the ground substructure works and currently ahead of program. Blockwork masonry walls have been completed in the museum basement tunnel, which has allowed the painted and dust sealant finishes to be applied to walls and ceilings. This has allowed the installation of high-level MEP works to progress with chilled water, sewage, domestic water supplies, firefighting, cable trays for ICT and security to progress. Located in the southeastern corner of the site is the contractor's precast facility, which will fabricate the museum raking grand stairs and Minka Rao's stairs members, sacrificial formwork that will form the top slab of the third floor double slab that will house the majority of the artifacts. Also, the precast facility will produce all the stairs to the museum, conference center, and multi-function parking complex. With daily toolbox discussions prior to each day's working activities and weekly health and safety initiatives, all the labor is kept abreast of all the latest site-changing environment and communicated lessons learned from daily working activities that are constantly being monitored to ensure the safety of the laborers, who are always the first priority. With approximately 3,100 site operatives working days and around 400 working night shifts, the safety and the well-being of all site workers are the BOJV's primary concern. Panoramic views from the initial temporary site office's rooftop in the northeastern reaches of the project site, looking back over the site activities and the impressive Giza pyramids. The extent of the expansive temporary site access roads network servicing all the open work fronts can be truly appreciated. In the northwestern corner of the site, the multi-function parking complex is coming out of the ground, with substructure works progressing in advance on the contractor's master program. The completion of these substructure works are dependent upon the temporary access road being diverted adjacent to the northern military site boundary to allow site traffic to go around and allow substructure works to the multi-function parking complex to be completed. Multi-function parking complex pad foundation substructure works progressing, with waterproofing and backfilling work to follow to reach the ground floor slab level. Panoramic views from the west looking over the conference center completed reinforced concrete works, panning south over the entrance court, which provides the primary access route feeding the main building works, and the Menkar Rao's wall with waterproofing, drainage and backfilling works progressing to the south. The temporary site mosque, which had to be relocated to allow excavation to the Menkar Rao's wall phase 5 to progress, is being rebuilt adjacent to the site canteen facility and is planned to be operational later in November. Subcontractor storage of material facilities are being expanded in the northwestern corner of the project site, which has access from gate 2 and 3. These will primarily house the materials of Haz Marble, who will supply and install all the internal tiles and external landscaping paving. These temporary facilities will be dismantled to allow the permanent retaining walls, landscaping, paved walkways and roads networks to be finalized in the later stages of the project. Southern view showing the extensive level differences and ongoing excavations that move the stockpiled sands to those areas that backfilling is progressing. The site is ever-changing with the day-to-day operations, which demands that site access roads and logistics remain open at all times and forever changing to the demands dictated by the pace of construction and sequence of works to ensure program is maintained. The Menkar Rao's wall phase 5 blinding has been completed with following unraft foundations and retaining walls to progress in November. Views of the Giza pyramids that will on day grace the millions of visitors can be appreciated and will delight all who have the opportunity to visit what will be without question regarded as the world's best museum. B6 Orascom are exerting every effort to make the new home for the Egyptian antiquities and inspiring the development of a new iconic architectural landmark.